Dear students, in today's problem of railway engineering, we will solve different types of problems. Okay, so let's start with the problem. What we have to calculate is maximum permissible speed for the given values. 1 degree curve for Rajdhani route and speed is given as 130 km per hour, which is maximum speed. And E is 50 mm, length is 60 meters. Okay, so start with the solution. As I have told you in the previous problem, that first step is always we have to calculate radius of curve or radius of curvature. And next step is in this problem is safe speed, which can be calculated by the formula V equal to 0.2 sin under root CA plus CD into R. Next, third step is speed based on transition length, as we have done earlier also in last problems, by using formula on two conditions. Vm equal to 198 L by E and Vm equal to 198 L by CD. From this, which is less, we have to consider or take in consideration, and along with that we have to calculate Cant gradient. Okay, so step third is completed. Next, in step four, we have to calculate maximum sanctioned speed, which is given value is 130 is given in our problem. 138.3 we have calculated and 118 is also we have calculated. From these three speeds, whichever is least, we have to consider as maximum permissible speed. Now, next, move towards step fifth. This is the main body of your solution. This step is very important. So in this step, we are going to calculate optimum value of maximum permissible speed. So how it can be calculated? We have the formula for calculating equilibrium superelevation as actual Cant plus Cant deficiency for maximum permissible speed for transition length. It can be calculated by the formula GV square by 127R equal to actual Cant plus 198L by V. This is the formula which we are taking. In this, we have to calculate V value, which is not given. Substituting all values from which we get V. We got this much. Next, therefore, maximum permissive speed can be calculated by the formula CD equal to 198 L by V. We are getting 91.4 mm, which is less than 100. Therefore, for our solution, maximum permissible speed over circular curve is 130 km per hour. Why we are taking 130 km per hour here instead of taking 133? Because in question itself it is mentioned as maximum permissible speed is 130 km per hour. That's why we are taking 130 km per hour, and 133 is exceeding that value. Therefore, we are taking 130 km per hour. And that over the transition curve is 118 km per hour. Hope you understood it and this is clear up to here. Next problem is we have to calculate negative superelevation. In this problem, we have to calculate negative superelevation, which to be plotted on the branch line. And also we have to calculate maximum permissible speed on the main line for the given values. What are the given values? Degree of curvature and slope and maximum permissible speed on branch line as 30 km per hour. This is the given data. For this, we are going to calculate the first step. In this step, what we are doing for a branch line track, the degree of the curve is 4 degree minus 3 degree equal to 1 degree. From where we are getting this? How? Suppose this is your main line, okay, from which this line is branch line. This is your branch line, okay, and this is your main line. Therefore, 4 minus 3, 4 degree minus 3 degree equal to 1 degree, always. 3 degree is given in the problem and 4 is the main line. Therefore, 1 degree. Next, radius of curvature, we know the formula. Next, superelevation can be calculated by the formula E equal to gv square by 127r. Therefore, this is also calculated. We get 6.8 mm. Therefore, we are making it up to 10 mm because higher multiple of 5, as I have told in the last problem. Now, next step 2. In this step, what we are doing? We are calculating negative superimation for branch line. We have the formula x equal to e minus cd. We have the values. Just substitute, we get negative as mentioned in step itself only. Next, step 3. In this step, the super elevation to be provided on the main line track is 65 mm, which is the same as the super elevation of the branch line track, but in the opposite direction. This is step 3. Now, in step 4, what we are going to do is actual super elevation of the main line track, that is 65 mm, and adding it to the Cant deficiency, which is 75 mm. Now, super elevation becomes adding both actual and Cant deficiency, actual super elevation value and Cant deficiency value, that is 65 plus 75, we get 140 mm. These two we are adding. Therefore, the main line track has a 3 degree curve as given in the question, this value. So that is, we have to divide by using R equal to 1750 by D. This formula we are using in radius. Okay. Therefore, the maximum permissible speed on the main line track can be calculated by the formula E equal to GV square by 127R, from which we have to calculate V value. V can be calculated. We got this. Besides this, another method is there to calculate V value is V equal to 0.27 under root CA plus CD into R. From this also, we can calculate V value. Therefore, after rounding it off to a lower multiple of 5, it becomes 75. Why it is 77? That's why we are making it to the nearest value as 75 km per hour.